Hello and welcome to my commentary position high above the valley ground at Charlton, where I'm expecting to be joined by Goldie the Eagle at any moment. We're here really to see the second division game between Charlton Athletic, the home club, and Bolton Wanderers. And the talking point for Charlton supporters is that this morning their club signed John Snedden from Arsenal at a fee of £15,000, and he takes his place in the Charlton side at right half. Let's see him and his new teammates. Well, Snedden there at right half, and to make way for him, John Huey, the long-serving Charlton player, moves back to right fullback, a position he's played many, many times. Well, Charlton in some difficulty at the moment, at the bottom of the second division. They're fifth from the bottom and only 3 points from the bottom, whereas their visitors this afternoon from the north, Bolton Wanderers, are fifth from the top and making very gallant efforts to get back into the first division at their first attempt. And this is the team they've brought to London this afternoon. Two very familiar names there, you'll notice. Eddie Hopkinson, the old England goalkeeper, still playing in goal for Bolton, and Freddie Hill there inside right. Well, these clubs are going to be hard put to it to provide good football this afternoon. We've had snow in the wind, there are snow patches on the pitch with some water, but at least it should make for a game full of excitement. And the three backs facing us there, the inside trio of Bolton Wanderers playing away from us in this first half. Our camera's behind the goal today. Number 9 there, Matthews. Number 8, Kennedy. And the inside left, Peacock. And you can see the pattern of the playing surface there. Snow, mud and water. And it's Butler now for Bolton up the right. And Bolton making the first mark, or at least thinking they've made their first mark. In fact, the referee has changed his mind and given a corner to Charlton Athletic to be taken by Rose. Control that has it today, that's Kennedy inside. And Bolton clear.
Wow, they're number.
Bolton. And that's what's going to happen this afternoon. Kenning for Charlton. And the short ball won't do today. Bromley to Hill. Bromley. Throw in to Charlton Athletic. Special interest today for Charlton supporters in their new right half. John Snedden signed from Arsenal this morning. And it's a brave man who's going to do much of that this afternoon. Back passing to the goalkeeper. Ten minutes gone, still no score. Hill in possession. Tocknell for Charlton. A good one. Kenning. Kenning to Sneddon. Another good one back to Kenning. And Charlton now gets a free kick in very much the same sort of position. Just outside the Bolton penalty area and halfway to the touchline to be taken by Kenning there, outside right. Huey across to Kennedy. Taylor for Bolton. Kenning. River and Farimon there combining well, but the final ball is a bad one. And Lee there, obviously aware of the risk that Charlton take in these back passing, following up very assiduously. Edwards. Hill. Bromley. Back to his fullback, Harrimon. Offside there, Bromley, the Bolton inside left, offside. And Lee's away for Bolton, Butler. And it's there, Butler has scored the first goal for the visitors, Bolton Wanderers. 22 minutes gone, and it really was Matthew's goal there, Lee's goal there. He followed up extremely well and squared the ball to Butler. And Bolton are one up. Dispossessed by Bromley, and Butler has it again. Nice one. This should be held by the pitch. Just. And a corner to Charlton Athletic on the left. Taken by their centre forward Matthews. Huey. Now, does he pass back? Yes, he does. Hill for Bolton. Hopkinson collects. Lee is there. He must get a shot in. And Hopkinson did very well to hold that. Deflected off one of his defenders, and he was had to change his mind in midair. But Hartle for Bolton clears it to Glover. To Butler. Butler's still chasing it down the right. He's round Haydock. Taylor. And Charlton under considerable pressure there. I think it's clear now that Bolton are very much appreciating the need to swing this ball about. They're now really beginning to move it. Corner to Bolton Wanderers. Takes it a little too far and collides there. Free kick to Charlton, quickly taken. Huey. Good one. Throw in to Charlton Athletic. Glover to take it. Well, the snow showers have kept off. We had quite a few snow showers before the game began, but quite a keen wind. Oh, dearie me. And Matthew's taking a mud bath there in that pool in the centre. He's still fighting for it. Glover has it. And it's still in the lake there in the middle of the pitch. So is somebody, but I don't know who he is, his number's been completely obscured. And the ball bouncing about now in a furious manner. The player's quite incapable of clearing from this waterlogged area. In the Bolton area of the pitch. And it's out. Extremely difficult to play football under these circumstances. Hatton for Bolton. Glover. Snedden. Huey. Bolton away with it. Bromley, they're inside left. Lee dispossessed. Well, this is a very unfortunate start for Snedden with his new club, in the sense that I hardly suppose he'd have wished for such a pitch to play on in his first game for Charlton Athletic. To Hartle. Lovely. and the wings are the place, the only place I would say at the moment, where progress can be made, and the more use can be made of them the better. That's the sort of thing that happens when the ball gets in the pool in the middle of the pitch. It's a pool, I'm sure, which is spreading as the players churn up the turf, and as the day wears on, of course, it's gradually thawing out now, patches of white becoming shinier and wetter as the snow melts. Free kick to Bolton. And 15 minutes to go as Charlton survive another attack, one goal down in their match with Bolton Wanderers at the Valley. And conditions underfoot quite desperate. Hatton to throw in for Bolton. Edwards. It's Kennedy. Very difficult in front of goal to put the ball exactly where you want it for a shot. Edwards. And I would say now that apart from one or two areas in the corners nearest to us, the white snow areas have now completely melted. Certainly in the centre of the pitch and at the far end. Charlton trying to move it about now. Hatton for Bolton. To Lee. Swings it across. And offside, Charlton's inside right, Kennedy. Five minutes ago in this first half, Bolton Wanderers leading the home team, Charlton Athletic, by 1-0. And a keen wind now beginning to blow down the pitch against Bolton Wanderers. They have it in their faces. So they're probably very grateful there's only 5 minutes left. And undoubtedly they'll have the advantage of the wind and whatever snow there is at their backs in the second half. And with a goal under their belts, I'm sure that's a very reassuring thought. Hill to Taylor. This is Butler, the scorer of Bolton's goal. Rose gets it. Kenning. The ball flying around in front of the Bolton goal at the moment. Hatton should clear it here. No, he doesn't. And it's still not out, and Huey, can he heave it over? He puts it square back. To Seddon, Seddon back to Huey, a long high one. And legs and feet virtually uncontrollable on this surface, and it's Rimmer just in front of the Bolton goal who is injured. Rimmer, the Bolton right half. And there you can see the sort of state the players are in. Spattered. Can I assure they're the warmest 22 people in the valley at the moment. And the snow now sheeting down. Fine snow. Edwards heaves it away. Hill heaves it away. As Charlton press to equalise before half-time, all their players at the moment in the Bolton half. And it's Lee. This is the boy who's loitered about and run about with great energy. Appreciated that in these conditions the ball can arrive almost anywhere. Hill for Bolton. Ball held by Kinsey, the left fullback. Hill has it. Through to Bromley. Bromley for Bolton. Floored in the penalty area, and the referee has given a penalty to Bolton Wanderers. With about 2 minutes to go now before half-time, Bolton should go into the lead. They're one up, and a penalty is there. Inside left Bromley was floored on his way through. Certainly a bleak prospect for Charlton to face now, with its lead to take it. They've got to face the sleet and the wind in the second half. They're already one goal down as Lee shapes up to take it. And now they are two goals down. Bolton Wanderers 2, Charlton Athletic 0. And I would say deservedly. Bolton! 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 Peacock. Bolton! Glover. And Hartle can't get it clear. Caught in a pool, he eventually pushes it to Rimmer. Hill keeping very wisely to the edge of the pitch. Hill again. Hill still in possession. Just keeps it in. Bolton still pressing as the referee blows for half-time. And the score in this match, Charlton Athletic, the home side, 0, Bolton Wanderers, 2. Well, you've seen only too clearly the conditions under which this game is being played here at the Valley this afternoon. They're getting steadily worse at the moment. The pitch underfoot is getting muddier and muddier. The wind is getting up. We're now getting a sleet of snow against us. And in the second half, it's Bolton, the team at the moment lead by 2-0, who will have it at their backs. So Charlton, the home side, face a really a very difficult second half with the weather entirely against them. 2 goals down. Let's see what they can make of it. And the backs there of the Charlton inside forwards, not understandably, for this second half, they've changed their shirts at least, and most of them, I notice, are wearing clean shorts as well. Charlton playing away from us in this half, facing a 2-0 deficit against Bolton Wanderers. Huey clears away for Charlton. Certainly already Charlton facing this second half with a certain amount of fresh go and verve. Out of play, throw into Charlton Athletic. And a goal kick to Bolton Wanderers. Well, at least the snow has stopped since the interval, and the wind dropped just a little bit. What wind there is towards us as you look at the pitch behind Bolton Wanderers. Lee. Bolton still containing Charlton's attacks very comfortably. Hill. Short on sticks. Lee in behind this one, but just too far, and Huey to snip. Snedden. And a good long one there by one of the Charlton inside forwards. Hill for Bolton. It's Lee. Very strongly built is Lee. You can see the shape of him there. Barrel-chested man, ideally suited for these sort of conditions. So this midfield slog goes on. Oh, it's just missed. Hopkinson dropped that one. Time stood still for several moments while everybody, I think, waited for the ball either to go in or for the referee to stop and award a free kick. But in fact, had that ball gone in, it would have been a goal, because he's now given a goal kick to Bolton Wanderers. Ten minutes of the second half gone, and the visitors Bolton Wanderers still leading Charlton Athletic by the two first half goals. And the players at the moment happy enough to move the ball without being too concerned as to where it's going. It's an achievement in itself to move it through the quagmire of this valley pitch. Bolton now in a strong position here, and a side for a corner to Bolton Wanderers. Their outside right, Butler, to take the kick. Cleared by Tocknell, but Bolton back with it, beautifully controlled by Freddie Hill. A shot here, and very nicely blocked by Haydock, the centre half. Tocknell. Players having rather more difficulty than those of the Bolton side in keeping their feet. They're with it now. Canning. The ball doesn't move for him at all. But he's back tussling with Lee. Freddie Hill. Lifted effectively. Lee, the centre forward. Lee's still with it, he's round Haydock, who's struggling. Other ball straight across the goal mouth. At least two Bolton shirts there, unable to stick a foot to it. And it's clear to Huey. Well, what is a chance and what isn't a chance on this pitch? I suppose on many a ground, a ball across the goal mouth like that would have been considered scorable from, but it's so difficult to move. Once you're committed to going one way, that's the way it's got to go. Throw in to Bolton Wanderers, just inside their own half. Just over Huey's head. Taylor's shot blocked there by Haydock. And a corner kick to Bolton. And Charlton clear. A huge heave back, which is partially deflected. Lee just gets his head to it. Hartle. Bromley. Lee to Butler. And this is good stuff from Bolton. Yes, it's there into the side netting. And a very good move that. The goal was scored by Bromley, the Bolton inside left. 15 minutes of the second half gone, and that's Bolton's third goal of the match. A very good movement in which they move down the light, down the right here, and with about five quite deliberate passes, contrived to put Bromley in a scoring position. He took it very well indeed. Haydock intended for Sneddon, but it's Tocknell who puts it away. Bolton come back. Lee, their centre forward. Throw into Charlton. Freddie Hill. Butler. And Bolton now controlling the ball and finding their men very much better, I would say, at the moment than Charlton. Bromley bringing it down. And Lee, the man putting the ball there to the corner, very much in evidence. He's played a strong, intelligent game. Corner to Bolton. Matthews. Haydock. Peacock's pass straight to a Bolton defender. throw in to Charlton Athletic. They've made some ground down the left there, halfway into the Bolton half. But there's not a white shirt there, and it's cleared out to Hill. Hill to his inside man. Charlton are thwarted again. Hartle. And a complete miscue there by a Charlton player. And throw into Bolton, quickly taken. John Huey. Taylor was away there. It's possible the referee might have played the advantage. Really, he's given the free kick. Already, as you can see at the bottom of your picture there, spectators beginning to drift in a disappointing fashion home. Five minutes left for play. Taylor. Snell. Peacock, the inside left with it now. Comes out to Freddie Hill. Taylor running on. Running on to it with great anticipation. Rose clears. Peacock. It's a good one. Glover takes a swing with his right foot. It's very high and very wide. Matthews out to Kenny. Difficult one. This could scramble in. Somebody's a favorite. Consolation goal for Charlton Athletic. Scorer Matthews. So Charlton pull one back, and the score now Bolton 3, Charlton 1. And the crowd at least momentarily heartened as Tocknell brings it away for Charlton. Just a couple of minutes left for play, and very good shot that by Butler. Which gets him a corner. No, indeed, it's a free kick for an infringement I didn't see, just inside the Charlton penalty area. Peacock, Matthews, Freddie Hill for Bolton. There can only be stoppage time left now as Charlton take a throw in and try to progress their last time down the left. At Peacock's. And Charlton having a very spirited go towards the end of this match. Kinsey for Charlton. And that's Kinsey kicks the last ball of the match. And very deservedly, the visitors from Lancashire, Bolton Wanderers, have beaten Charlton Athletic in this second division game by 3-1. Well, with Bolton Wanderers beating Charlton Athletic by 3-1 here at the Valley this afternoon, the respective positions of these two teams in the league table, Division 2 league table, have been thoroughly justified. But whatever other merit separates these two teams in that division, there's no doubt that on a pitch such as the one we've seen this game played on this afternoon, that Bolton were so much better equipped to cope with it. They seemed heavier and more thrustful. Players like Lee at centre-forward and even Freddie Hill at inside right, normally regarded as a ball player, seemed to have a great deal more thrust and power on this heavy pitch. And Charlton, on the other hand, by comparison anyway, seemed very fragile and not to have the same thrust and power at all. Well, as a result of today's matches, there's no change really at the top of Division 2. Bolton still stay in fifth position as a result of this win for them this afternoon. But Charlton will undoubtedly sink a little because one club below them, Middlesbrough, got a point. So as a result of this game today, Charlton's hearts will have sunk a little further. And sank they did in this mud here this afternoon.